The Swammi Burrito Show is coming up next, so I want everybody to stay tuned. We got Swammi in the house. We got somebody that looks like Colin Powell or some crazy fool. And we're just going to have a wild, crazy show, so stay tuned, all right? All right.
You're just a crazy
God bless.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, look. It's the Swammi Burrito Television Show, dude. Oh, yeah. That dude's back. Wait, what about that other guy? Wait,
another day.
Oh, there he is. That dude is dope. Hey, I remember those guys. This song rocks. The guy's a tampon.
So I'm
get out of town.
Hey, what's up? If you don't like me, you get
dude, I'm tripping. What's up? Help.
What's
oh, I see.
Take before you know what it's
well, take it away, boys.
Take a look around.
And to one bingo, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls.
Wait a minute. We're doing White America Day, so we gotta go.
We got to come back with
yeehaw.
The yeehaw. Down to down down.
All right now. Say, Mama went to the store. Then she came right back.
So whenever, matter of fact, if you could bring that music up for us in the studio.
Kick the music, please, gentlemen, in the studio.
So what's going on out there? I'm Swammi Burrito.
Burrito.
As you know.
God bless Swammi.
The show that's on for No Blow, it's all here because of you know. That's terrible. Mr. Shu, what's happening?
What's up, Swammi
How you
Burrito?
Doing?
How you going? What's going on?
Oh, it's another lovely, fun Saturday. We're here wasting as
wasting
usual,
time, having
time.
Fun. You know, my favorite thing is to come kick it with you, Swammi.
Oh, hey. My brother, I hear you. Matter of fact, let me introduce, of course, Mr. Max Epad.
That's E-pad? Correct. That's correct.
Oh, you look a little.
You know,
different.
I don't consider this wasting time.
You don't consider this wasting time.
As a white American, I tend not to waste time.
Huh,
I don't really do that.
You're
as a white biker American.
To that, white American. Today is the theme of our show.
Right.
We want to know why you out there, yes, some of you out there that are watching, we want to know why you're proud to be a white American. Now remember, you don't actually have to be a white American to be a white American.
Yeah, just look at me.
Just look at you. Well,
I'm a white biker American.
Oh, hey, watch out now. Because if you didn't come on a hog, they're going to put you on a cow.
Bro, I got my Harley outside.
Okay. You got your Harley?
Harley.
Okay, we don't want it.
I don't want to ride no horses.
And as usual, you know today the show is live, and there's the number. And we always take phone calls from our lovely assistant or assisting audience.
Right, right.
You know what's happening?
Yes, our fellow white citizens.
What's going on with you today, by the way, Maxi Pad?
Well, I'm trying to get in touch with my whiteness. You know, I'm trying to establish... kind of a fortress of whiteness.
So did you have cornflakes for breakfast then with orange juice?
Yes.
Do you hold your ass real
I
tight?
I had sea rations and with cornflakes.
You had sea rations. Is that like a stereotypical thing of white America?
Some of us, yes.
Well, really, you know, when I woke up this morning, all I could think about was trying to make money.
Me too.
I mean, that's basically what I consider white.
It's all about the money.
You know what I mean? It's all about
right,
the
right,
money.
Right.
My phone calls as usual, so we'll take one or two. And in about 2 minutes, I'm going to be giving a little patriotic speech or a little patriotic commentary.
Right.
If you'd like to say.
Hey, now you sounded like Black America, Swammi.
No, I'm Black America.
Yeah, I mean, your lingo, you was like, we're coming
wait. Yo. I can come across like this and still be a white American.
That's acceptable.
Okay.
Look at him.
Okay.
I forgot rap
point.
Has hit the suburbs.
Very good point.
All right, let's check with the phone calls. Who do we have on today with Swammi Burrito, Max, and Mr. Shu?
Shoemaker.
Limit, what's up? Tell me it's no limit, right? It's no limit.
No limit?
It's stone limit?
Limit.
Oh, limit. Leonard, I'm sorry. Leonard, sorry. Leonard. What's up, brother? What's going on today? Why are you proud of me? What's that?
I want to see your nipple.
Oh, I can only tease, I can only tease you with one. Now stop that, boys and girls. Stop it. Stop it. Just stop it. Leonard, so what's going on there? Why are you proud to be a white American? Obviously because you can easily pick up guys on the telephone.
Bye.
That went dead.
Wow.
God.
Hey, look who's at the door.
Hear the country music in the studio when you get a chance there. Let's check on the phone with someone else. Who do we have on with Swami? Hello?
Hello,
what's going on? We're white America. How are you?
I'm all right.
White power.
My name is Timothy, and I'm calling from jail. And
Timothy!
I'm on Monday.
Oh, man, you know who...
Because I always wanted to know. I had a question for Magnum P.I. on the right. I always wanted to talk to him, and I had a question.
Magnum P.I. Timothy, hey.
Huh?
Timothy, slack on the syllables.
You know why they call me...
Slack on the syllables.
You know why they call me Magnum, right?
You what? Hey, there you go.
I have a question for Mr. Magnum.
Yes, yes. Ask away. If it's not top secret, I promise to answer it.
You know when you were trapped in that that goop prison?
Oh, yeah.
And you had to put out with just a toothbrush and a maxi pad?
Hey, by the way, my brother's a gook.
Is this crazy,
right.
Lenny?
So don't be putting any of those down.
Okay. I fought in the Vietnam War, and that is just...
Oh, wait, I'm sorry.
Let me tell
sorry,
you. Let me
I'm
tell
sorry,
you a story.
I'm sorry. For any...
Oh, please. Okay, that's okay.
Any friends that you have, I don't mean
you
any.
You know what, senor?
But I need to know how he broke out with just a toothbrush and the paper.
Well, I will tell that story right now. What happened was,
I chimed in right at the right
we
time.
Were surrounded. We were in a jungle thicker than an Iranian girl's pubic hair. And about 200 of them came from the left and the right flank. And so you've got to understand, all I've got is an AK-47, about 245s and a knife. So what I did
so
is I went straight through
don't
the middle.
Crazy. Okay.
Good, I'm glad to see a weapon on the stage
that's
at this
right.
point.
I am all a white American, I have my gun.
And basically I snuck under a log and waited for them to all run by me, and then I got out and made my way back to...
But I need to know how you escaped out of prison with the toothbrush and the toilet paper roll.
Well, don't you understand he used that Armenian thick pubic hair brush and he scrubbed his way out like a shovel.
Also,
it took a while.
Also,
I had... You look at his fingernails, they're almost worn down to the bone.
I see. All right.
Well, thank you for the
phone call,
my
brother. I thought he just bit his nail, though.
I also put the toothbrush up my rectum and shot it and hit the guy right in the throat.
That was a good shot.
Hey.
Yeah, it was.
It was. Yeah.
That was
all I had to do when I was there was establish my rectum control.
Well, that's good. Good thing you had gas, too, huh?
Damn.
You don't need gas if you have rectum control.
You know how to use your booty muscles.
That's like your sphincter muscles just putting up so much energy and tightening up and just going,
it's like a blow. They I learned it from the gooks.
Hey, do you do buttocks exercises or something?
Yeah.
My son is
Hey,
dying.
I never.
Nicholas, Daddy will be home soon, Nicholas. Daddy will be home soon.
I want to say one thing right now.
What's that?
I never killed any women or any children.
Oh, very good. Unless, of
course,
they were...
And that's the God's honest truth, and I know that in my heart.
Unless, of course, they were rounded up in, like, the whole city, right? And then you guys just leveled everybody, like Senator Kerry did.
Well, there were times that we, but I'm a close combat fighter, so I always see my target before I detonate.
Now, let me ask you a question.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, Mr. Shu, don't you have a question for this man to ask?
Yeah, I'm wondering, with the butt shot, when you shoot from your rectum...
You're fascinated by
that. No, I'm saying, how do you do that? Do you do buttocks exercises or something?
6 years of practice. I mean, unless you want to sit in a Viet Cong prison for 2 years and rehearse and, you know, practice, I don't think it's something I can just tell you how to do right here.
Oh, okay.
Well, you know what? Because this is public access, we can talk about it, but we can't show a visual.
Right,
thank
right,
God.
Right. Yeah, really.
Well, I can do a small demonstration if you like.
No. Please,
please don't do
down,
it. Please don't
sit
do
down.
It.
Don't get carried away. And for God's sakes, keep your hand wherever.
Sit down, white man.
Please. Let's give a phone. Let's check on the phone calls because I'm going to give a, I think, you know, in about 30 seconds, I'm going to give a patriotic speech so everyone understands the theme of today.
Okay,
let's
white boy.
The phone call.
All right, white boy.
Who do we have on today with Swami Burrito, Mr. Shu, and Max? Hey, what's up, Mr. Quinones?
Hey, white boy.
That's
Hey, what's happening, brown boy?
I'm black.
You're black?
You're black.
Quinones?
Damn.
Man, you guys got someone in the woodwork. You know what
you
I
don't
mean?
Sound like you have any cojones.
No, he said his cojones? Is that cojones?
Cojones.
Pinchones.
Oh. No.
I know some Spanish, Swami.
I know one or two words.
You want to hear my words?
Okay, wait.
Five dialects.
The ghetto go ahead.
The ghetto. The ghetto go ahead. Wait,
the ghetto go ahead.
Puerto Rican.
That's the ghetto go ahead.
That's a little Puerto Rican, homes.
Is that Puerto Rican?
Did you jump the border?
No, man. We're only going to Taco Bell later on after the show. Thanks for the phone call.
You know, I want to say something about the border. The white man is the only man who will stand at the border and say no more. Well, it stops here.
Let me inform white America in the studio, please. I'd like my accompanying music. If you
this
please.
Is an inspiration well, to all of us.
Go ahead, white boy.
My fellow Americans, today we celebrate White America Day. Not for the glory, not for the majesty. No. It's because this show is run by retards.
Right.
We here at SBTV understand the need for lunacy, idiocy, and absolute stupidity. Hence Mr. Shu.
Very good, very good.
But when all is said and done, if that's possible, Americans need a cause. A cause, well,
true.
Because.
True, true, true.
We need to bring back white America. You might be saying, Swami, but I'm not white.
Hey, I don't want to go back into slavery.
That doesn't matter, nor does this speech. We aim to stop the insanity.
Yes.
Stop the injustices for the average Negro.
Hey.
Slanted eye. Brown skinned foreign language speaking citizen.
Right on.
We can all strive to be white by thinking right.
White is right.
So get on the ball. But don't play with it. Join today. So together, we can bring back the righteousness of America. Brothers and sisters, I say hallelujah.
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 Thank you
to the white boy
very much.
And the white man.
And let's take a phone call, please.
Please.
Thanks for that timing in the studio.
We only want white phone calls today.
I feel patriotic right now, don't you? Who's on with Swami Burrito, Mr. Shu, and Maxi Pad?
Thank God.
Hey, oh, Jamaican. We got Jamaica on the phone, brother.
Jamaica. Is it a white Jamaican?
Hey, my brother, you can be a white American. I'm sorry, what was that?
What's your problem with Jamaicans, man?
No, we got no problems.
Oh, we like white Jamaicans.
Don't you?
No, don't you understand? This is about white America. You can be you.
You can be you.
Be your dialect. You can speak
this
like
is
if you.
Sword.
Wait. First, you have to master the language when you try to be. When you try. Hey, oh my God, my brother. Hey, man.
Hey, man. Hey,
don't be upset. Don't
hey,
be upset.
Hey, Swami. Swami, okay. Swami, I have a certain urge to say I have a dream speech now.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay, well,
please
you
don't.
Know what?
But it's just what?
What is that? Please don't. You know, wait, my brother, before you do that, we will give you a second.
Hey, Colin Powell, you better watch
the
yourself.
Studio. We have some examples
of
some people that want to show us, or actually tell us why they want to be a white American.
Oh,
in the
white.
Studio whenever you get a chance there, Mr. Dave.
I like the term.
Sometimes I forget that's what I am.
I like being a white American because I can do moves like this in the club. Oh, wait a minute. Isn't it the other way around?
Being a white American because the money is good.
I like being a white American so I won't have La Migra at my front door.
I'm a white American because I'm spunky.
I like to be a white American so when I cross the border, I won't get hit or beat up, get my ass kicked. Second of all, I would like to be a white American. Since I have two left feet, it will be okay. And third of all, I would like to be a white American so my friends won't make fun of me anymore about the way I talk.
I like being a white American because I can drive my convertible Beamer through Beverly Hills without getting pulled over.
I like being a white American because we're all so yummy.
We're rolling.
Huh? Oh, the camera, we over here? Hey, Mama. I like being a white American, you know, because I've been able to move up the corporate ladder, you know, real fast and everything, you know, and I've been, you know, things been just really great for me, you know. My portfolio and everything is blowing up, like, bam!
White American porque me gustan las gabachas.
I'm happy to be a white American because I can marry George Wallace's daughter. Bye.
I'm a white American because I love drinking Heineken and because it makes you say, what are you doing?
Recording.
I like being a white American because I am so stuck.
My name is Uncle Tom. I'm here today to talk to you about why, as a white guy, I love living in America. You know why? Because our justice society, Justice Department, the laws, they're the best. I want to talk to you today about the BMD law. I'm sure you've heard of it, the Black Man Driving Law. I think it's the best darn gosh this law I ever heard of. I just love it. I'm driving down the street, I don't have to worry about traffic. I don't have to worry about the cops pulling me over, because they're already racing with the black man, because of the black man law. My name is Uncle Tom. Stay cool.
I love being a white American, because I'm Irish-Italian. And it's okay to be a complete lazy alcoholic when you're a white American.
Best thing I like about being a white American boy is the fact that I can say, play the funky music, white boy.
Well, as
hey,
you can
that
see,
sums it all up.
Plenty of people out there that wanted to express
proud
their
white American
patriotism.
Hey, I like being a white American too.
You are the whitest.
Well, you know why? American. Because I like jumping on my Harley and just rolling out, bro.
Let's jump in phone calls and check who's on with us today. Who is on? Swammi Burrito and Mr. Shoe and Max E-Pad.
Max.
Who are we talking to?
Shitty Pad.
They jumped off already.
Hey, this is Fishamajig.
What's up, Fishamajig? What's up?
What's your majig?
I'm proud to be a white American.
Why are you like being a white American?
I'm also proud to be a black goldfish.
He's a black goldfish.
Hey.
And you must be priceless.
And I eat at Wolfgang Puck's, and I buy my Destiny's Child CDs. Shout out to the Olsen twins.
Yeah, as long as you don't say anything perverted.
Hey, Mary Kate, I'll be over later. Love you.
Thanks, brother. We'll talk to you later.
That was
I think
funny.
Everyone understands what it is to be a white American
white
out there.
White American.
You know what I mean?
There's nothing like it.
As a matter of fact, we got about 10 minutes left, so we want to make sure that we got Mr. Maxi Pad here, who's looking very, looking very...
trained.
Contemporous. He's ready to demonstrate what white Americans need to know when you walk outside of your house, because you just never know.
Sometimes you might have to defend yourself.
Lurking around your corner.
Right.
Why don't you guys go ahead and set up there? I'll take a phone call.
Okay, so right now I should turn into a black American.
Right here, I'm going to take a phone call. Who do we have on with
here,
Swammi
Burrito? I want you to stand right here.
What's happening, brother? We're talking about
stand
white America
here, get
today.
In the kata position.
Isn't it? Don't you love it? Are you a pure white American?
Oh, totally.
All right. What's your favorite pastime?
My favorite pastime is just watching TV, yo.
Oh, cool. You know, mine is to masturbate.
Oh, really, dude?
Yeah, that's cool. It's this.
Like masturbate in front of me, dude?
Oh, cool. No, I can't do that because then my wife would get jealous. Talk to you later. Okay, that was pretty pathetic, wasn't
well,
it?
After
I'm
that...
Okay, you're going to be... Okay, well, that's going to be easy for you. Maxi Pad, why don't we just go ahead and take over right here? Let's demonstrate some of those moves you were talking about.
These are some simple militia type tactics that I've picked up over the years, of course, doing several different odd jobs. Well, yeah, of course, you would be, just act normal how you would normally act. Okay.
Shoot, because you ain't got a mic.
If you're accosted or approached by a African-American individual, such as this one, what you would do is you'd come in, and first thing you do, hands down, right about here, and you'd go, oh!
Wait.
Oh, damn, dog. What? That's it. That's it. End of demonstration.
I know you weren't expecting that when you were done.
What the hell was that?
Max, wait a minute. You had a couple more. Get up there.
Won't we do a few more?
What the heck's going on?
Hey, don't hurt me, bro.
Please, don't get it. You shot your wad once, but you can have. I'm sure you can reload.
Oh, well, I'll show some other simpler ideas.
You know what? There's a guy, as a matter of fact, on this station that is really good.
Oh, yeah, he's good. He's good. Definitely good. Definitely good.
You go and perform on Venice Beach, I heard.
Yeah, no, these tactics are more generated, focused on the African-American tactics. All right. So
okay,
one of the things
well.
You like to do is, because they tend to be tall, so you can hit them right up here, right in the armpit, right there. There's a ball of nerves there the size of a grapefruit. It'll take you right out.
I've never seen that move before. What is that? How does that incapacitate the blackmail? As if
there's a ball of nerves up there.
Oh,
and it's already weakened from all the basketball that they do. That area is particularly weak. You can knock that ball right out of its socket.
I see. Very good.
So then,
okay, hold on a
then,
second. Hold on a second. I want to see if any phone callers are out there, because they might have a question for you while you're there. You know.
Right.
I mean?
Right. Okay, any questions regarding?
Ludo Mamo with Swammi Burrito and Max Epad and Mr. Shu with some defense techniques for white Americans. Who are we talking to?
Hey, Hillbilly.
Hey, Hillbilly, come on now. I'm just keeping nice and cool, you know what I mean?
Oh, okay.
Hey, what's going on? What's your name?
Ivan Hernandez.
Ivan, well, first of all, we don't need your last name, but that's cool, Ivan. Okay.
Oh, okay.
But no, that's okay if you don't want anyone to call you right now.
You're the 28th
now.
Caller. Remember, you don't win.
By the way, Ivan, there, just so we clarify, what's your address so we can make sure that you belong to this cable area?
I don't know my address.
I don't know.
I gotta turn black on him.
Hold on. Let's get a question here for Max Epad. Who are we talking to? Oh, wait. Hold on a second. We got a black man. See? Okay, here. This would
fine.
Be
this
the
is
perfect
how you, yeah.
point of view right here.
If
he Who are we talking to, sir?
He was to approach me.
My name is Leroy.
Leroy. Okay, Leroy is on the phone. Leroy, do you have a couple white boys named Leroy. Okay, Leroy, hold on one second. You got a question for Max and any self-defense techniques?
I have white parents, but I'm a black child.
Okay, you have white parents, but you're a black child?
Yes.
So they just keep you out in the sun
it's
a little?
Very rare.
They just put you in the oven a little bit too
I'm
long?
I'm black hostess.
You're a black
hostess.
It's
the M&M syndrome. It's the M&M syndrome.
Black hostess. Yeah, you know what? Do you have a question for Max?
I'm not a player. Why couldn't you got no black folks on your TV show?
Well, because today is White America Day. Didn't you understand the premise?
Every day is White American Day.
That's
that's right. You better get used to it, son.
You have to think positive, Leroy.
You better get used to it.
You have to say to yourself, look, I'm a horse. Any obstacle I can leap over, especially because I'm fast. Thank you, Leroy.
All right, let me show you one last thing, one last
let's
tactic.
Go ahead. We got like
all right.
5 minutes.
So say you're in hand-to-hand combat.
Okay.
Say, pretend he's got a knife in this hand, all right?
Okay, he's got a
he's
knife.
He's got a knife in this hand. So what you want to do is, oh, he stabs his own hand. He
okay.
stabs his own arm.
Uh-huh.
That starts arterial breathing,
uh-huh.
and then you can get a knife and stab him in his spleen. And then if you hit him in the spleen, then it'll be about 2 hours before he dies
now,
a painful death.
Now, I've got a question for you.
Yeah.
Shoo, here you go for a second. Why don't you take that now?
Okay, this is perfect.
Now you got a black man with a gun. What you gonna
do? Right into my head. It's one of the most dangerous situations.
Uh-huh.
Not because...
Don't pull no Jackie Chan
not
on
because,
us, okay?
Whoa.
And don't break the studio, please, boys. Please. Boys and girls, don't break the art man. Let's check
right.
out of the. Let's check
so,
the
those are pretty much all the
you know
tactics.
What? I think we will end that.
You
okay. Hold on a second. Let's see if anyone's got a phone call for you two guys. Who do we have on with Mr. Shu, Swammi Burrito? That's who I'm supposed to be. And this is MaxiPad and Mr. Shu. We're doing self-defense techniques for the white man. Who are we talking to? All that, no one's there. Thank you very much. Who are we talking to on Swammi Burrito Television?
Hey, this is Fisher Majig again.
Hey, Fisher Majig, what's happening? How did you like that demonstration?
It was awesome, but you're hating. You're a bunch of haters.
No, we're not haters. We're a bunch of players. We're just a bunch of players. We're just a bunch of players.
Hey, what do you guys think of L. Ron Hubbard?
L. Ron Hubbard.
Lakers.
You know, well, you know what? I have to tell you something. The guy is great at science fiction. You know what I mean?
Science fiction!
He's done a lot for the white man, though.
Hey,
a lot of white people have low self-esteem.
You know what?
Because they see all the basketball players and all the rappers and all the black people on the Jewish media. And what happens is,
relax for a second. Take a breath.
Hey, Swami.
Yes. What's going on?
I like the idea of a black man having a gun.
You like that?
Yeah, I
do too. Except when I go, you know, driving my car. That's the worst. Matter of fact, I almost got into it with somebody, but that's another show. Jig-a-ma-jig. You know what we want to know is
You almost got up into someone?
Yeah, I almost got up in someone's ass.
Oh yeah.
You did.
I almost got in someone's ass. You know what I mean? Well, it wasn't very.
Hey,
hot.
White boys don't
like
fight. They
never get out of
angry.
The vehicle.
More like an aggressive.
Like when you grudge to it.
The guy couldn't. He rolls down his window. He goes, "What do you care? I don't care. I drive fine. You stupid white boy." I swear to God, just like that, I almost ran him over.
That's the type of stuff that'll make you very angry.
He
it'll
pulled into a 7-Eleven real quick.
Last week I had an incident and I crucified somebody. Like they got me so upset, I had to hang him up and I crucified him.
Did you hang him up by his
testicles?
No,
I crucified him on a crucifix.
Did you light the cross afterwards?
Yeah, and then I lit the cross on fire.
Good.
Did you light in front? Did you put in someone's front yard?
Yeah,
No, the whole bit. He did the whole 9 years.
Now that is white America. Thank you very much, Thingamajig. We're going to go to another phone call because I think we got a couple minutes here.
I like being a white American because I can bob my head like this.
This person's been on the phone for a while. Don't, hold on a second, brother. Hold on here.
Let me is that Timothy McVeigh?
No, hold on. Let me clear your throat.
Timothy McVeigh?
Okay, go ahead.
Timothy?
I cleared your throat. Go ahead.
Is that Lick Plummer?
Who are we talking to? Is this Timothy McVeigh?
Yeah.
Timothy, I can see you're a little tongue-tied. What did you call today for?
I can see you're a little Montana. Shocked.
Are you having
get it? Time? Shocked?
Oh, is this guy masturbating on the phone?
I don't know. I think
we're
he hung
jump
up.
To another
was it going
phone?
Like this?
That's too nasty for me.
Hey, what was that?
Who are we talking? I don't know. Someone was doing something. Who are we talking to? This is Swammi Burrito. We got a couple minutes, I think, and Swammi Burrito. And did I say that already? Swammi Burrito.
You forgot to say
about
Mr. Shoe.
Swammi Burrito, Mr. Shoe, and Max Epad, our self-appointed self-defense self-director. What's that? Who are we talking to?
Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Ricky Dick.
Hey, Swamp.
Not a tricky dick. Not a tricky dick.
I want to try my white boy handshake.
Oh, okay. Oh, why don't you come over here and practice on Mr. Max Epad while we talk to Tricky Dick.
This is how white boys.
Are you with KKK?
No, am I? Hey, come on now. Look it. All right? Just between you and me, brother. Okay.
White boy handshake.
Hold on a second. There's you guys go ahead. Just between you and me.
All right. Okay, let's say I approach you. I say, hi, how you doing?
I'm trying to have fun.
Right.
The boys are right
that's
now.
Good.
They're drinking
good.
A Jack D
good.
With the little
good.
Kids.
Okay,
matter
good
fact,
firm shake.
I know one of them's with their little
okay,
daughter
good.
Right now in the back room. Okay, I'm trying to keep it on the low pro, all right?
So what are you doing?
We don't want... Oh, no, well, not today, because I'm already a member. Thank you very much.
Who? Of Mensa?
No, of KKK. Who are we talking to?
He was from the Triple K?
Hey, that's a good sound, by the way.
Once upon
a
time,
I went to a party and I saw a little girl.
I'm warming up for tonight. We're going to do a shigaboo. A shigaboo with the rest of my family. We got all of them coming around. We're going to get around a big pit fire.
There's nothing wrong with drinking a couple six packs.
We got this little China girl where, you know, we're tired of her. We've been using her.
Yo, man, you hurt me when you was doing your demonstration, dude.
What's that?
You kind of like gave me a little cut on my finger.
Let me
when
tell
you,
when you got that blow to the nut area, the nuddle area, I swear, you were white there for about a whole second.
What'd
for
you say?
One second, you were white.
When I had my nuts, what?
When you got that foot right to the nuts.
You got a laceration on your hand?
Yeah, bro.
We'll get a couple sutures in that. You'll be fine.
Let's
stop
check
crying
see.
Like a
who
little girl.
Let's check you see.
My God. What are you going to do when a real African-American approaches you?
I'm going to
cry and go, oh, I got my finger lacerated.
Hey.
Who are we talking to today? I was Swammi Burrito Television.
Oh, yeah, I just stayed out of African-American neighborhoods.
No. Hey, hold on a second. What's up? What's going on over there, bro? We're talking about White America Day. Are you a white American?
No.
You're not?
No, man, I'm black.
Oh, okay. Well, no, but you are
you
white
still
American.
Can be white, bro.
Yeah, look at us. I mean, look at us.
I'll tell you this.
What's up?
It's trying to white boy shit.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. What was up? What's up? Wait. Take the bowl out of your hand first. Take the pipe. Put the
hey,
bowl
that's
down.
A black man with a gun.
No, I'm sorry. Wait.
He's
no,
smoking a
blunt.
Philly blunt.
Put the blunt down. I'm sorry.
Oh,
put the blunt.
No.
I got to know what's up. You said Compton.
Sorry,
you said Compton, right?
I got my blunt too, bro.
Hold on.
Bro, I got
hey.
My blunt
right,
too, so
hey,
we're here.
Yeah, we agree with you.
I got my blunt too.
We do agree with you on that one 100%. 420.
420.
Or
20.
You get smoked. That's what we want to get smoked.
Well, yeah. Well, I mean, we're not.
We'll talk to you later, bro. Hey, don't get serious, man.
Hey, man. No, chill out. Chill out.
None of those techniques would ever work unless you've done all the training that I've done.
When all is said and done, you're just purple.
And you're just a black man with a gun.
Hey, you guys are cool, but that nigger's a fucking idiot.
Hey, thanks for the sling. What are you, S.A.?
Yeah, fool.
Hey,
what's
you a
up,
white boy
fool?
From the hood?
What's
you
up,
one
fool?
Of those white dudes
don't make me put a cap in your.
You driving an Impala and you have a buzz cut?
What's up, dude? What's up? You won't say that in my face, dude.
Your name is Slim Shady or Casper or Goofy.
How many color Pendletons do you have, Holmes?
I'm your worst nightmare.
Fool.
I'm the white man on the TV controlling this channel.
Yeah, dude.
Wow.
Mother sucker.
Kind of
that was
Eddie
a
Murphy.
Serious one.
Eddie Murphy speech.
Yeah, he almost got capped.
You know what?
He almost got his ass capped.
He only got about a minute left. Matter of
okay,
fact.
Okay, yeah.
I mean, it is a plastic gun, but he will cap you.
I will bust
I think there's
cap
some caps in there, Matt.
Because I'm a white man
He's
with a gun.
He's going to put a cap on
that's
you.
Your worst enemy.
He is a white man with a gun.
You'll only pry that from his dead, lifeless
I
hand.
I carry this on my Harley all the time, so don't try to carjack my Harley.
You're going to try to carjack your Harley?
Yeah.
How are they going to do that?
They can't. I'm a white man with a gun.
I guess, are we wrapping up there, Gus? Oh, yes. Well, I can see we're wrapping
here
up.
Here we are.
Let's take a phone call. Let's see. We're wrapping up. Who are we talking to? Who are we talking? Wait.
We're out of here.
Who are we talking to?
It's all over.
Did the sack fly?
Did the who fly?
Did
Yes, it did.
Fly on top of the wall.
Yes, it did.
Yeah, so there's basically protons.
Well, no, we went splat, and he was dat.
Just like that, dude.
Who do we have on with the last couple seconds?
Hey, niggas.
Hey, what's happening, brother? White America Day. Thank you very much for watching. Swammi Burrito, Mr. Shoe, Maxi Pad, contact FCC, SBT. Beautiful. I mean, what is that? Go ahead, anytime. That's just a roll. Oh, I was very angry when I first came in here. Hey, everybody, it is me. Oh, Swammi Burrito. And it's another Saturday show. I'm here with Mr. Shu in spirit. Well, no, actually, Mr. Shu has been transformed. He's sitting in his usual place, as usual. We'll get a shoe. There he is. How you doing, Mr. Shoe?
All right, man. How you doing?
All right, very good. Thank you. We have an angry show today. We have some ridiculous guests that idiot right there, Mr. Shoe, booked. I have no... Some doctor. I don't even know what the friggin' topic is. But you know we're live. There's the number, as usual. We got music. And, of course, we need your help to waste 30 minutes of our valuable time. And as I can see the lines, let's check in one phone call right now. Who do we have on with Swammi Burrito?
Good evening, this is Mr. Sap.
Mr. Sap, how you doing? You're not a sap, though, right? You're a smart guy, right? You're a smart guy.
Yeah.
What the hell's going on out there? Hold on a second there, partner.
Okay.
You know what? Let me tell you something before I let you go.
Hold on.
I drove in on this freeway.
Yeah.
And I got cut off 4 times. You know what?
What?
4 times, bro.
Wait.
4 times.
No.
You know what? If I didn't have a Mac, whatever that gauge is, a Mac something, I watched hip-hop videos in the 90s, but, you know, a Mac something, I would have used it. I wanted to 4 times. I'm tired of it. Aren't you crazy? Aren't you tired of those idiots out on the road right now?
Tired of the sap that goes inside the tree and it goes inside the cardboard. What's wrong with it?
Hey,
what'd he say?
He said, I don't know. He's a sap. He's a sap. I don't know what he said. Thanks, Shu. Shu, do you understand what I'm talking about, by the way?
Yeah, man.
Yeah. As usual, you're chiming in with lots.
You sometimes I want to bring up my Nina and just you know.
Are you really?
Just unload it.
You are absolutely right. But let me get back to our audience, Mr. Shu, and I'm going to bring out our guest in a couple minutes here. But let me tell you something. I am sick to death of all you effing idiots out there that don't know how to drive. The first lane, that is the lane furthest to the middle, is the fast lane. The lane next to that is the second fastest lane, third fastest, and so on. Morons, you can follow with whatever your moronic ideology understands. You understand what I'm talking about? I don't know, that's an oxymoron. Go fast in the fast lane. Don't go fast in the slow lane. That's where you're gonna kill people, like me, and I don't wanna die. Tired of it. I just want to be able to smoke my, well, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, yeah. Tell me about it, right? Did you light up before you got in here today as usual?
I always light up.
Oh man, you're smoking right now.
Yeah.
Let me check in with another phone call. Who are we talking with? Who do we have on with Swammi Burrito? And we'll have our guest out here in a minute. Don't worry about it. We got somebody to talk to besides this idiot face. But who do we have on?
My name is Grover Nicholas.
Grover Nichols.
Grover Nicholas.
Oh, Grover Nicholas. Grover Nicholas.
I want to say that, Mr. Shue, I'm so pleased with the tremendous progress that he's made. You probably know yourself that one of the stipulations of his parole is that he's not supposed to go within 50 yards of a Caucasian woman, and he's followed that very well, as you probably know. We've just got his third urine test back. So we've given him a lot of chances, and I think this time it really looks like it's going to work out.
Well, you know, I'm glad you brought that up, Grover, if I can call you Grover.
Absolutely.
Okay. Basically, you know, we got this smelly old shoe here because it's a representation of his ass that isn't here today. But apparently this thing, you know, he is, like you said, he's in a lockup, but he's doing some stupid play. And I guess he's locked up in San Diego somewhere. And the funny thing is, it's a Shakespearean play. Now, I'm trying to picture, I'm sure not as well as everybody else out there, Mr. Shoe doing a Shakespearean play.
Well, that's one of these stipulations. If he acts in a play, he will be immediately returned to prison. I wonder why the symbol says, does it say SOBTV? Is that what it says? Yeah,
no, SBTV, Swammi Burrito TV. Should be TV if it was TV, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Hey, well, thank you very much, Grover. We'll talk to you later. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Mr. Shue.
Yeah.
We're going to bring up this guy better. All I can tell is, if this guy ain't, I'm going to put my shoe up your ass. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I know. It's fine.
All right.
He's good, man. Don't worry about it.
All right. We got good music today, too. You guys like the Pretenders. Well, without any ado, Mr. Dr. Abar Babar, ladies and gentlemen. No, sir, excuse me. You didn't have to go around. Okay, that's fine. Have you ever heard of a razor, by the way? I'm sorry, just have a seat.
You don't do something.
In my country, it's not traditional to cut the hair.
Yeah, I can see. I'd hate to see what your women look like. Dr. Abar Babar, you know what? I'll be honest with you, sir. I have no effing idea what the hell you do. This idiot, that's my upstage hat.
Yeah.
This idiot over here booked you. He told me that you're a specialist at some hospital that has some investigative report to you're opening up this investigation on where you work at or something. And I was like, well, what the hell is he talking about? He says, Shue said you could explain it. So please.
Shue is a very good friend of mine.
Yeah.
And we're talking. I drive cab now. So
what now?
I drive cab now.
He's the best
what
drive.
The hell? He said you're a doctor?
Hey, I know what
you're
talking
about. Hold that thought. Who's on with Swammi Burrito and Dr. Abar Babar?
How's it going today?
Hey, what's going on? Who is this? Is this like a family member?
How you doing? Hi, cousin. Everything's okay over here. Don't worry about me. Listen, my friend. I heard that you want to know about guns. It's called a Mac-10.
Oh, a Mac-10. Thank you very much. You know what? I'm so...
Is that an Israeli weapon?
Yes, I got plenty. You know you keep them under the house. Me too.
An Israeli weapon.
But listen...
Do you have a problem with the PLO?
No, really? I'm talking to your friend.
Excuse me, we are talking to you. So, do you have any actually, let's find out what this guy does together, because I have no idea. What is your specialty? But hey, you got to turn down the reverb on the TV there, chum.
Okay, I'm
there. You go, that's all right.
First of all, I have a question for everyone in the audience.
Okay, well, he's one of our audience members, so talk directly to him. He's on the phone.
Who is better, Kobe Bryant or Allen Iverson?
What the hell question is that?
Well, personally, I think Vlade Divac is the best in the NBA, but that's just because I'm biased.
Vlade
Divac. But I do like Kobe.
Hey, Kobe, come on, guys. Let's not veer away from the subject. We already know who the best is. You're going to 3-peat, 4-peat. Jackson will retire with 10 rings. He's going to marry Jerry Buss's daughter. Everyone knows. Thank you for the phone call.
You are right, Swami.
Yes, that's why I'm a Swami.
Yes.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Shue. Thank you very much. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, in a couple weeks, we'll have another show. We're going to have a much better guest than this I mean, you, no offense to you, sir, but I have no clues to
I
what
want
you do.
The truth
hold that
to
one
come
second.
Out.
The truth. Hold on one second. In 2 weeks, we're going to have, I guess the woman's name is JJ, and if you ever check her out, she's on hotpotatosex.com, and she's a stripper.
Pamela Deter.
Pamela Deter. Oh, you know this young lady.
Yeah, I go to her website many days.
Oh, very good. Well,
hey, no
check
websites.
It. Hey, oh, I'm sorry. That's right. No websites. That's right. I totally forgot about that. The Swami, that's a faux pas by the Swami. But she'll be here. She has a specialty. She's a vegetarian of sort. She does things with vegetables.
Hey, does so she like doing things with carrots?
She like, you know what she does? She uses potatoes and she creates art. She creates art with a scalpel. Let me put it like that.
Yeah.
But listen, Dr. Abar Babar, can you please fill me in why you're here today? Because I'm gonna go to the phone. But go ahead, talk
well,
to us.
Well, I was I drive cab
second.
Now. I drive cab now, but
you drive cab
a year
what
ago.
What the hell, Shu?
No,
what the hell
but
is...
he's true.
He told me you're a doctor at some hospital. You work
no,
at a hospital.
I was caretaker at hospital, not doctor. I never said I was doctor. I do medication,
hold
I do cleanup, I do cleaning, I do make, I
sound
make
like
bed.
You're a janitor. Who do we have
no,
on the phone?
No. I give medication
hey, Mahmoud,
too.
Wait, we have another one of your country, hey, Mahmoud.
Mahmoud Mohammed,
are you, by the way, are you a Muslim, sir?
Which Salman Rushdie.
Salman Rushdie, no.
Which Salman you with?
You have offended the dignity of the Quran. You have no dignity. You, what you have done is disgrace.
You are a disgrace.
Yeah, I think we need subtitles for the show.
It's not true. It's not true. I am not disgraced.
Subtitles. You said we need
I
some
subtitles.
Okay, you know what? Can you guys do some Farsi right here real quick and just get it out of the way so I can just please.
Fatra futra fatra.
Hold on a second, let me get that out of you. Mahmoud, do you have a question for this guy? Well, you know, I thought he was a doctor.
A year ago, I was fired.
Hold on, he's got a question, hold on.
Right on the table, I want you to put it only on the table that you indeed are Mr. Rushdie.
You are Mr. He wants you to admit you're Salman Rushdie.
I know.
Are you Salman Rushdie?
My name is Abar Babar.
This is Dr. Abar Babar. Thanks for the phone call, Mahmoud. Hey, Dr. Abar. So what is it that you're trying? What are you trying to bring to our table?
Hold on
one second. This is my show, okay?
Sorry.
All right, please. I don't want to have to bring out my whipping stick and put your palms up here on the table. Don't they do that in your country?
In my country, it's for this. What we're doing here, it's off with your hands.
No, I heard it's like whipping, and then sometimes if they really get upset, they put your penis in a drawer and smash it!
Oh, that happened to me.
Flat wiener syndrome, it's not very
good. Third grade.
Flat wiener syndrome. So what is this, what are you trying to...
I'm trying to get the truth out. And they told me I was fired because I went out with someone who was at the place where I was working.
You got fired because you were with a you had sex with somebody at work? What's the big deal? It's like an employee you're talking about, right?
They were not employee, they were client of the place where I was working.
Well, you worked at a hospital, right? I thought, I thought this guy was a specialist. Any ideas? What's the deal here?
I don't know, man. He was just telling me lies.
Oh, man. What the hell? Okay, so what the hell? Yeah. Okay, so you got fired because you had sex with some employee.
No, well, it's a patient. So they say
Wait.
Because I'm going out with patient.
What do you mean you had sex with a patient?
Well, it's not just sex. It's a relationship.
She was dead.
What?
She was dead, man. She was dead.
No, you are not a necrophiliac. You are not no necrophiliac.
No, I never. After they are dead, I am not touching.
What do you mean after they're dead?
What?
I said, what do you mean after they're dead?
When I'm working there, many people dying. I'm not touching them.
Well, what kind of hospital is this? Is this like an old? Please don't tell me you're doing the old folks. Let's take a phone call because you're trying to gross me out, bro.
Many people.
You are trying to gross me out. Do you have a comment for Dr. Abar Babar? This guy's revealing some that I'm not too quite sure about. Who do we have on the phone?
You have losses.
Yeah, I'm sorry?
Losses.
Losses?
Losses.
Lasses?
Yes.
Like Lhasa Apses?
Yes.
What is, exactly. No, I don't have that. I have a Doberman Pinscher at home.
Pinscher.
Okay. Okay, so what's your question for Dr. Abar Babar? Hey, put the bong down.
Yeah.
Put the bong down.
Abar.
All right. Okay, here we go.
Abar, my friend from the sand. How are you?
Assalamu alaikum.
Don't get racial over here.
Balaga.
Okay, what's up, bro? Well, you can release the hit now.
It's been many years since I walked on the sand.
I got good shit over here.
I'm sure you do. We wish you could share with us, but what's your question? Share your question with Dr.
Are you using the hookah?
Are you a doctor or not?
No, I'm a caretaker.
You're
I'm trying
janitor.
To explain
this. Guy's a janitor. Thank for,
where,
as
where
usual,
are you from?
Sure, thank you very much. What's that?
I am caretaker.
Where are you from?
This is, I'm Swammi Burrito, bro. This is Swammi Burrito TV. But this is Dr. Abba. He is, well, we were just uncovering something about
the border.
He said he got fired. He's upset. He had sex with a patient.
What country is he from?
What country are you from, bro?
It's not so important.
What the hell is that on the tip of your nose? Do you got hair everywhere?
Have you ever been to the Mecca? The almighty Mecca.
I walked around it a couple of times.
Okay.
Is that the Mecca Mall over there on Ontario?
No, it's the one in Iraq.
The Mecca, the wall.
It's been many years since I've walked around it. Mecca. Anyway, I have a case, and maybe Johnny Cochran's taking my case, because what they are saying...
You better not be having sex with old people.
Well, elder, old people, young people, it doesn't matter what age. Not important. But at the hospital, my girlfriend, Sally, is the only one who is treating me nice all the time.
What do you mean your girlfriend, Sally? You got a girlfriend at the...
She's a patient there. A special patient.
Wait. Have you ever heard of ethics? Ever heard of ethics? I bet you don't even use toilet paper. Don't put in that finger this way, bro. What's that?
She has no arms and legs, man.
No, don't be going there. She's not like a Wait.
She has...
How old is this chick?
She has a leg and a half.
A leg and a half?
Well, yeah, off the knee is no leg.
Oh,
but
man,
that is
what?
Accident, a long time ago.
What happened from the accident?
They lost the knee, off the knee.
Is she a comatose or something?
No. Just, she hit her head very hard.
She hit her
window.
Head.
And so she's not, everybody's saying she's not so smart. I think she's very smart. Very smart, very special.
Wait a minute here. What do you mean?
What
do you mean she's very smart and she's very special?
She's like Rain Man.
No way! You are, get the.
What? It's not that
you're
problem.
Having sex with retarded people, aren't you?
I don't like that word.
You are sick.
I don't like that word. It's not right. It's
who
not right,
have,
that
this,
word.
Who do we have on with this? This.
Hey, it's Tony. Hey, sweetie.
Tony, this guy just says, did you hear what he's just admitted to?
Yeah, I heard what he said, but he's lying.
He's not lying.
He is lying. I know he got fired. He's trying to cover his ass.
You were not there.
Yes, I was there.
Go ahead, Tony. Tell us
what's talking
up.
About.
Come on, Tony. Tell us what's up.
He worked in a hospital. Hey, he worked in a hospital.
Okay.
Right, and he did the cat-taking and did all the other various things, but he was also one of those guys that went around and saved all the privates before operations.
Oh, yeah.
Now, right, when I was in a car accident, I couldn't feel my lower half of my legs, and he's shaving my pubes, and I'm just yapping away because I talk too much anyway. And the next thing I know is I look down, and he's fucking sucking me off.
Oh, here. My God!
Now he's fucking hairy.
Oh, my God!
I can't even hear it.
Oh, my God!
That was not me.
He didn't even save me. You know, it's terrible. It's horrible. That's why I got fired, is he kept giving oral sex to these...
Hey, is that your hair in his face right there?
Right here. He took it and glued it on his face. That's what he does. All his victims, right? He takes all of his victims' pubic hair and glues it on his face. He's like leather face and
what the hell?
Put together.
You think that wig is the same thing?
Hey, man, you still got the flavor on there?
No, it's good.
Hey, thanks, Mr. Shu, for that commentary.
Mr. Shu, you're okay, because I like someone with soul.
He's love got you, more Tony. Soul. Thanks for the phone call, brother.
He's got more soul than he's ever had.
He's got lots of soul. Mr. Shu, you got lots of soul today.
Thanks, man.
Hey, man.
Mr. Shu, thank you for inviting me.
Hey, yeah, what the hell is this? This guy's doing retarded people,
but
Mr.
that's
Shu.
Not, that's my case. This is not illegal. It's not illegal. Who's saying it's illegal?
Hey, man. Hey, he's a talented man.
This, you're talented, all right. Yeah, you know how to scam on everything that's 75 and below, IQ-wise.
Hey, it's not important. IQ is biased test.
Is a biased test?
Yes.
Well, when somebody says yes, yes, and then, you know, they're talking about, you know, eating poo-poo, they don't understand the difference. Does that turn you on or something?
I take care of them. No matter what they eat, put in their mouth, anything from, it's okay.
It's all good, man.
Oh, my God. I think something's in your hair. Who's on with Dr. App? I mean, this guy.
I am caretaker.
This guy is a total mistake.
Because they are firing me, and I will sue.
Mr. Shu.
I have a question.
What's going on? Who do we talk to, first of all?
My name is Eduardo.
Eduardo, what's going on today?
What do you get when you cross a Swammi Burrito and Maxi Pad?
What's that?
What do you get when you cross Swammi Burrito and Maxi Pad?
What do you get when you cross a Swammi Burrito and Maxi Pad? I don't know. What do you get, Eduardo?
Very dry burrito.
Very
dry.
Hey, who?
Ernie.
Who?
Ernie.
Dick.
What's that? Come visit me after.
What's that?
Come to my house after.
All right.
All right, later.
All right, bye. You, a dry burrito. You,
I bet. That's amazing, they're thinking that things.
You're an idiot. You know that? What the hell is that on your nose? Is that a growth from?
A birthmark.
What's the?
See, you're like everybody, always making fun, looking at my face. Oh, look, look, look.
Look.
It's very funny.
It looks
very
like
funny.
A spider.
You guys are like little kids.
You got spiders? You got crabs? You got crabs, huh? You got piojos? Stay over there, man, bro. Stay way over there. You got piojos. Oh, that's disgusting.
It's okay. It's okay. Listen. I want to make it very clear.
Checking with the phone callers, huh?
Hey, those are some flags.
All the girls in the hospital.
Hey, hold on a second.
Hello?
Yeah, who are we talking to?
My name is Henry.
Henry, what's going on? We're with Babar. This guy is.
He used to work in
this
the.
This guy is a janitor. He's doing retarded people, and that's why he's upset he got fired.
I know. That's my niece he's doing. I gave permission. It's quite all right. I'm her legal guardian.
Now, what was your name again?
Her IQ.
What is your name again, sir?
I'm sorry?
What was your name again?
My name is Henry.
Henry, you're telling me that you gave this thing here authority to have sexual relations with your niece?
I'm her legal guardian, and she has free will, and she wanted to date that man. She said it was okay with her, and I'll tell you the truth.
Henry, I gotta ask you something.
The ugly little...
Henry, hold on. Take a breather. I gotta ask you something.
Thank you, Henry.
Hey, go ahead.
Are you retarded yourself?
No, I'm not retarded.
No, you're not retarded.
I don't like that word.
Hey.
But I gotta tell you something.
What?
Gotta let her make her own decisions. She is smart enough to make her own decisions.
She's not even smart enough to wipe her own butt.
Crab-filled decision.
She is 24 years old.
Terrible thing. Hey, can I ask you a question, Akbar? Did that crab solution work?
It's working better.
Yeah, that's good there. Yeah, you know.
You are disgusting.
It's working better.
What the heck? You know what?
Look,
I don't know.
You invite me on the show.
Do we have?
You invite me on the show.
Oh my God, we still have 5 whole minutes. Sit down.
Sorry.
Sit down, please. What's up, Shu? You were gonna chime in, or are you late as usual?
Yeah, I'm late as usual. I was gonna ask you to ask that guy if he had a cousin named Cooter.
He's got a cousin named Cooter with a sling blade.
Hey, I don't know what you're taking, Shu, but you're much, much quicker today.
Let's see who's on. Who's on with Swammi Burrito and Babar and Mr. Shu as usual and from one form or another?
Can I just tell you guys are not funny?
You know what? You can tell us.
Thank you. It's very serious.
For the next 5 minutes that we're not funny. And we'll listen to you. And we'll take some advice.
That's really sad.
Yeah, how could she help us?
Well, you know what? Do you have, like, something special between your legs that we can suck on?
Of course.
Because I'm getting turned on just by your voice.
Yeah.
I really am. You can't tell right now. And it's better that way. You keep your nose over there, dude. You're doing the wrong people. Who are we talking to?
She sounds like a mean girl.
Did you jump? Oh, she already got off the phone. Oh, she's a little pussy.
She got nothing better else to do.
She's a little pussy.
Her comments were good, though. Very good comments.
Hello.
Who do we have? Man, you got a lot of countrymen calling up today.
Abar.
Abar. Hey, Abar Babar.
You take away a freedom and you go on this show.
This guy's doing retarded people, man.
What is wrong with the plans? Your friends.
You don't have, you don't mind doing that? You don't mind doing that? Don't you want some, like, a woman that knows what's going on?
Exactly.
She knows. You want
don't you want a woman that feels and loves and has tenderness and you know, gives you that soul, interpersonal relationship feeling? Isn't that what you're looking for in a relationship?
Looking for a hoe.
Oh, well, that too, I guess.
All you have to do is come to America.
Hey, man.
All the women are whores.
Hey!
They're all mean to me.
Hey!
Your class and your sex machine.
And make
sure, fuck off.
Hey, thank you very much. By the way, make sure you pick up that package by the door.
Yeah.
All right?
Okay.
And I saw you. You dropped it.
You better dunk that in some water.
You dropped it. You know, and, yeah.
There
and
must
I don't want
to.
It's something's in there.
Maybe some C4.
We got like 2 minutes. Believe it or not, we made it through a whole half hour. A whole half hour. I still can't believe what you're doing. Don't open that coat either. Who do we have on with Swammi Burrito, Mr. Shu, and Abar Babar, the retard dude?
I would like to ask Abar a question, please.
Okay, Abar, well, you got a lot of countrymen calling up.
I am
don't
Russian.
Touch
I
that
am not
thing
Arabic,
while I'm around here. You got
Arabic.
Hold on
English,
a second.
English.
This guy's got bugs in his beard. They're flying through the street.
I know, but still, Akbar, yes? Akbar, I am an amateur rectal photographer, and I am doing a calendar, hairy apples over the world, and I would like you to pose.
Hey, I like that offer. That's all right.
Did you say erection photography?
I can set that up.
I would like very much a picture of my asshole. I've never seen it.
Yes, it is.
We got 1 minute.
It is an expose of the beauty of the asshole and the amazement of how ass is beautiful.
This guy, you know what?
My asshole, then I'll give you $10.
This guy really goes deep too.
That's
you know what I mean?
Though,
I know, but you have ever looked at your asshole in the mirror? It is fucking amazing.
Hey, thank you very much. Yeah, hey. Why with the syllables? You gotta slack.
I am terribly sorry. It is freaking amazing.
I know it's Farsi, but relax. Thank you for the phone call. We got like about 30 seconds. People have been holding on. Who's this?
Okay, I got one more question.
Go ahead, real quick. Who are you guys? The Abar, the retard hammering dude.
Yes, the Abar guy.
Abar is hammering the retard.
Thank you for having me.
Is he the one of the guys in the circus Mexican boy faces all hairy like that?
Oh, he does look like the dog-faced boys, huh?
He's the father?
Are you the father of the dog face boys? That's a lapsu.
I have had many sex in Mexico.
Lasu apsu or lasu upsu?
There you go. I love it. Thank you very much,
brother. We got the credits rolling. Listen to music. It's jiving.
Yeah, man.
You're a fag, by the way, doing retards. Thank you, Mr. Shu, as usual, for chiming in.
And then do the running man.
You're soulless.
Hey,
there you are. Let's just close on that idiot right there. There you go. Mr. Shu, as usual, thanks for...
No problem, man.
Oh my God, look at that thing on his nose. What is that?
Peace out, bro.
You must be from Europe.